Ladies and gentlemen, joining us now, yes, from the Ultimate Fighting War World, rather, there it is. It is war for sure. There is Ken Shamrock. And Mr. Shamrock, in your officiating last night, firstly, why did you stop the match?
Well, you know, I was in the match, and Steve Austin was in a great deal of pain even throughout the whole match. I asked him several times. He did not respond. As far as I could see, he was unconscious. I had to stop the match in order to protect his body, because he was in severe shape. So that is why I stopped the fight.
All right, but you did not hear him say
right.
The words, "I quit," did
right.
you? You did not hear him say the words, "I quit," did you?
No, the words weren't said, "I quit," but when a man goes unconscious and he cannot protect himself properly, that is why I was hired to do this match, was to make sure that one man won and there was no cheating involved, there was no holds here. And therefore, when Steve Austin passed out, he could not protect himself. So therefore, that is why I stopped the fight.
All right, but then, as he could not protect himself, the hitman, Bret Hart, after the match was officially over, went back and attacked Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yes, he did. And, you know, throughout the match there, there was a lot of dishing out pain going on in there. But one of the things that I guess that I had to step in on was, because after Stone Cold was on the mat and he was passed out and really could not protect himself, the reason why I stopped the match, Bret Hart decided to take upon himself to go in there and put more pain upon him. And from what I could see, he was trying to end Stone Cold Steve Austin's career. I had to step in and stop that.
Indeed. Well, the hitman wanted no part of you, no doubt about that. Let me ask you, as far as your opinion of Stone Cold Steve Austin, what is your opinion of him as far as last night's match is concerned?
Well, you know, me and Steve have had some harsh words in the past. I particularly really don't care for him much. But there's one thing you cannot take from this man. Let me tell you, he went through a lot of pain, and there was no quitting that man. He kept fighting and fighting. You gotta give him that. He is one tough character. I've seen a lot of tough people in my life going through the no-holds-barred competitions. And this guy is by far one of the toughest guys that I've seen.
All right, thank you very much for joining us, Ken Shamrock.
Shamrock can strike you, but he loves submissions. That's why ABC Television has termed Ken Shamrock the most dangerous man in the world.
I think you'll see that change tonight. You'll see Vernon White be called the most dangerous man in the world. He's going to surprise Shamrock.
Again, no one, ladies and gentlemen, has been seriously hurt
moment. Shamrock kicked right in the chest or the face. I couldn't see which.
No one has been seriously hurt in the Ultimate Fighting Championship. And Shamrock behind Vernon White.
Vernon White in the guard position, covering his face.
Shamrock taking some liberties here. And
remember, there's no pinfalls in this. Referee's gonna stop it. It's only an exhibition here. No sense in taking this kid's head off.
No, and
he's already bleeding. His nose is bloody.
I'm not so sure that Mr. Shamrock didn't really get angry with his opponent there. It was to have been an exhibition. I think it turned into a little bit more than that. And let's see if we can't get a word with Ken Shamrock.
I didn't see that. I saw him trying to block the punches.
But Shamrock's...
You're lucky, Shamrock. You're lucky, that's all. You're just lucky.
I wouldn't say that.
Must be quite an adrenaline rush to be pounding on somebody like that. I think we got the drift of your style. It is indeed no holds barred. Take no prisoners.
Well, you're supposed to start out as an exhibition fight. And I guess he got a little carried away, so I kind of lost my temper a little bit. But that's the way it goes.
Thus far.
Time!
Well,
it's time!
I'm going to work really through this interview here.
Well, you got that big grin on your face, Honky Tonk Man. You like that surprise.
It's
I don't think Vernon White liked it all.
It's
you sort
time.
Of wonder here.
It's Vader time now, Mac-Man.
Wait just a minute.
Take the gloves off, Vader. That's it. Go to work, Daddy.
my goodness. What's going to happen here?
He's telling Shamrock to bring it on.
Vader, ready to jump. Shamrock ready for it. Look at the look on Shamrock's face. Look into those eyes, would you?
You better get out of there, Shamrock.
Vader, a mastodon. I think Vader wants to try. Vader wants to try.
Bust him, Vader, bust him.
Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. We'll continue as Raw is War. Who knows what's going to happen tonight?
Vader bomb coming up.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, we're told Gorilla Monsoon is standing by. Oh, here we go. In just a moment to let us know what's going to happen if Sid does not show up to face Mankind. And thus far, Sid is not here, surprisingly.
You know, ever since the Final Four, Vader has become a ravaged animal.
Yeah, Vader, ladies and gentlemen. You talk about someone who can get down in a... What's... Oh!
Whoa!
What a power bomb! And a cover by Vader. And the count, and he gets him.
Here is your winner, the man they call
Vader. Victorious, ladies and gentlemen. Standing by is Gorilla Monsoon to let us know what's going to happen if Sid does not show up. Meanwhile, JR.
Well, folks, what turned started out as a big party in South Africa became an all-out brawl with security and everything else. I'll give you all the details on option six on the WWF Superstar line at 1-900-737-4WWF in the States, 1-900-561-WWF1 in Canada. And remember, kids, you gotta be 18 years of age or have your parents' permission before calling. But all hell has broken loose in South Africa in what started out to be a very nice night. More on that on option six.
And the man they call Vader, Victor.
Jimmy Cornette, honky-tonk man from Johannesburg. Can you hear me?
Yes.
One question. Why, while I'm watching this, it made me think, why did Vader fire you?
Vader didn't fire me.
Oh, wait a minute.
Vader didn't fire me. I sold his contract. Never mind. What's Mosh right, doing?
Mankind now with Mosh.
Oh!
Mosh with some sort of liquid spewing from his mouth into the eyes of Mankind. And I'm not so certain that Mankind isn't experiencing some visual impairment.
Look at it. He's clawing at his eyes like a wild animal. I don't think he can see. He's clawing at his eyes. He's just like The Undertaker. The same things happen to him that happened to The Undertaker in his hands.
Well, not the same thing, but there appears to be some sort of visual impairment in Vader Trent.
Wait a minute.
Mankind with a mandible claw. Mankind visually impaired. He thinks that's a headbanger. Mankind applying a mandible claw.
He's clawing him out. He's clawing him out. Look, the claw has worked on The Undertaker. The claw works on Vader. Nobody can stand up to the mandible claw.
And Paul Bearer trying to get Mankind off of Vader and finally does. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you here on the end, yes, ABC calling the world's most dangerous man. We're talking Ken Shamrock.
How you doing, Vince?
Thanks for joining us. We've got a big announcement tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, Ken Shamrock will take on the man they call Vader. No holds barred on May 11. Before we talk about that, however, Ken, we'd like to mention well, Vader right now, unfortunately, is detained. And the reason that he's in detained, well, he's in Kuwait. Why was he in Kuwait to begin with? Well, this was the second annual Kuwaiti Cup Invitational, was it not, JR?
It certainly was. Last year, Ahmed Johnson won the Kuwaiti Cup. And this year, it was young Tiger Ali Singh, who we hope to see make his American debut tonight. But Tiger won the 16-man single elimination tournament. We congratulate Tiger Ali Singh.
Yes, indeed. However, Mr. Vader was detained, as we all know. He is not here. Why is he not here? Well, he took exception to this announcer asking him if wrestling was fake. Watch this.
I find your remark and your question insulting.
It's not my question. It's somebody who...
Does that feel fake, huh? Does that feel fake? Does it? Why don't you come down tonight and before I kick his... I'll kick your ass.
Okay.
All right?
Just come, man.
Hey, we're not here to be insulted. I'm not here to be insulted.
Okay. Right.
Yes, and this Wednesday, ladies and gentlemen, we will find out the fate of the man they call Vader, somewhat being held hostage.
This is a very serious situation.
This Wednesday, Vader goes to court in Kuwait, and we'll find out just how he's going to pay for his crime.
Look at this. I did a little bit of artwork. You know, over in Kuwait, if you get locked up, they don't put you on a chain gang where you make little rocks out of big rocks. Look at this. They put you out in the desert, and they make you clean up camel manure. So and all those Scud missiles are flying around and everything, so I did this little
camel
picture.
Camel gun.
Yeah. Well, you know what it is. And they put the ball and chain around you. And let me tell you something else. This is not funny either. Look at the way they're selling Vader's action figure now. Look at that, McMahon. Whose idea was that?
Stop it.
He's going to be upset when he gets back.
Joining us now, ladies and gentlemen, the man who will face the man they call Vader. No holds barred, Vader versus Ken Shamrock. Ken, what about it?
Well, there's one thing that I don't like, and that's a bully. All my life, I've had problems with bullies. When I was a kid, I had problems with bullies. When I was a teenager, I had problems with bullies. And now that I'm a man, I still have problems with bullies. And I have a problem with Vader. And come Wednesday, after his trial, and he comes back to American soils on March 11th in Richmond, Virginia, he has a trial to attend to here. And I am the judge and jury of that trial, and I'm going to put an end to that bully.
Yes, indeed. Everyone looking forward to a no-holds-barred event on May 11th with you and Vader. Bullies, yes, are here in the world roster.
Yeah,
bullies are just about everywhere.
Let me ask him about that rumor that we've heard flying around. Can I ask him about that, huh? What's this about you and Mike Tyson? There's a big rumor going around, huh?
Well, if you close your mouth for a minute, I would speak about that.
Oh, that's so.
There's one thing I've been waiting for. My 8 years of no-holds-barred fighting has always been a question asked to me. What if you fought Mike Tyson? Who would win?
Huh.
Well, let me tell you something. I know who would win, but we will never let the public know who would win unless Mike Tyson steps into that ring against me. And I'm making a challenge on national TV in front of all the American people.
What?
Because Mike Tyson, as far as I'm concerned, is another bully. And if he'll step into that ring with me, I will prove to the world who is the world's most dangerous man. I've been told that I am the world's most dangerous man, but I'm willing to put that up on the line in the ring here in the WWF. If Mike Tyson thinks his rape charge when he was in prison doing time there, when he steps into that ring with me, he's going to be doing real hard time with Ken Shamrock. And if he's got the guts to step in that ring with me, I'm going to take him down and I'm going to put a hurting on him.
Mike Tyson,
I make the challenge in front of the world.
Hey, in front of the world, Mike Tyson would knock you out like a light,
Shamrock. Why don't you shut up and sit down and enjoy your retirement?
Hey, I am sitting down, Shamrock.
Oh,
and you'll be laying down if you ever get in the ring with Mike Tyson.
Please, Vader. We are about to experience Vader time here on Raw is War. Yes, he's back in the United States. Let's show you why, ladies and gentlemen. He was held against his will in the country of Kuwait as we take you now to footage from Good Morning Kuwait. Vader, watch this now.
It's not my question. Is somebody being...
Does that feel fake, huh? Does that feel fake?
Hey.
Does it?
Oh, no, no. Just...
Why don't you come down tonight? And before I kick his, I'll kick your.
Okay.
All right.
Just calm down.
Don't. Hey, we're not here to be insulted. I'm not here to be insulted.
Okay.
And of course, that resulted in an international incident. Certainly, Mr. Vader not representing the country of America, for that matter. Certainly not the World Wrestling Federation. Very well. As a result of those actions, of course, last week we had out here with us. Well, ABC calls him the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, who was talking about his upcoming no-holds-barred match with Vader. Also challenged Mike Tyson, by the way, and no response from Mr. Tyson.
Well, Shamrock showed himself to be a complete idiot. He might as well, why don't you go ahead and challenge George Foreman? He'll fight a bunch of nobodies like you, Shamrock.
Oh, please. Well, speaking of Shamrock, let's take a look now at Ken Shamrock, ladies and gentlemen. Get to know this extraordinary human being a little bit better. Here's a look at Ken Shamrock.
His image is cast in riveting yet chilling mystique, especially by those who have faced him.
I'm a challenger. I love challenges. And I always put myself into challenging situations.
And so I'm going to work to be the best.
To challenge myself. It's another chapter in my life, and it's a different challenge.
On the threshold of his greatest challenge, Shamrock relishes the opportunity.
And I can tell you this, the WWE is going to be the biggest challenge I've ever had yet, okay? Because I'll tell you this, it's not just going in wrestling. It has a whole tree that goes with it. You It is going to be probably the most difficult thing that I've ever tried to do.
The brief glimpse of Shamrock has been nothing short of impressive. With a single-minded purpose, he fears no one.
And I'm making a challenge on national TV in front of all the American people. Because Mike Tyson, as far as I'm concerned,
I don't see failure, you know. I'm afraid of failure. And so being afraid of failure is not failing. You just go out and you prepare for it and you do what you can do. And that word just doesn't enter your mind. You do whatever it takes.
His preparation has fueled his passion to succeed and embodied the spirit of his lifelong journey.
I think in a lot of ways, the will to win is the will to prepare to win. The reason why I am who I am is because of what I went through. And I think the reason why I look at things the way I look at them is because of what I went through. I'm a very fortunate person to be where I am right now with the kind of life that I had. But I had a lot of people help me along the way.
Here comes the little speedsters. What's up, boys?
Next time, we'll revisit that lifelong quest and come to recognize the man within the ultimate fighting machine.
Later, against Shamrock. What's going to happen in that one? No holds barred. Here in the World Wrestling Federation, ladies and gentlemen, in Richmond, Virginia. May 11th. Oh! And
here we go
with a clothesline on the big man. And Jesse James, to be victorious, is going to have to continue to do what he's doing right now. Keep the big man off guard. A lot of motion.
That's not the kind of motion we're talking about.
Too much size, too much power right there.
What's Vader weigh?
458.
Unbelievable.
I don't think he lost any weight while he was in Kuwait.
No. He got truck sales here in Omaha.
He's probably going down to some school and stealing some kid's lunch.
Oh, listen to you.
Well, he is
attitude.
A bully.
He's got an attitude, he has, King.
There's no question about that. Vader now. Uh-oh.
Peering out before this capacity crowd, and Vader! Oh, he hits it! I can't believe it!
Oh, my!
That should be all.
No.
Now, there right there is a great example of stupidity. Vader's got the match won, and he picks up Jesse James for absolutely no reason other than he's a 458-pound bully that thinks he can do any damn thing that he wants to do.
Oh, listen to you, Jim Ross. Why does that make him a bully just because he's a big, tough guy and he beats people up? Why does that make him a bully? Huh?
He shoves people around.
Look at
him. He takes advantage of people. Look at it. He's got this one. You think he's going to pin Jesse James now? Only if he feels like it.
Well,
and
he
finally,
did.
Showing a little mercy here, which is more than what we can say he showed to that poor Kuwaiti national, the broadcaster, who quite frankly was scared to death.
Well, I'm not scared to ask him some questions. That's what I'm
going
to do.
Where are you going, Ross? Look at him, man. What are you doing? What's he doing?
Jim Ross going up to grab a word with the man they call Vader.
Well, now he's got to be the stupidest man in Omaha.
I can tell you this, JR will be confrontational.
I'd like to ask you a couple of questions, if you don't mind. Everybody knows the ordeal you've gone through in Kuwait. I just want to know if you have any remorse, if you have any shame for the embarrassment that you put your family through, you put the WWF through, you put all these fans through. I don't care if they like you or not. You've embarrassed a lot of people. You have any remorse? Do you feel ashamed of yourself?
Tell the whole world, one time, once and for all, I went to Kuwait to do a job, and I happened to do my job very, very well, and that's beat up people.
Nothing wrong with that.
So as far as remorse or regrets, I'm gonna say it to you one last time. I apologize for nothing. I apologize to no one.
All right, a second question, if you have the moment here. As long as you've been in professional wrestling, I'm sure you've been asked a zillion times if wrestling is fake or not. Now, I'm not going to ask you that question because I don't agree with the question, but don't you think you overreacted just a little bit when this guy in Kuwait asked you a somewhat of a stupid question?
Is Ross nuts or what?
Hey, Big Mouth, you know what? I can finish that interview that I started over in Kuwait you right here and right now.
That wouldn't be advisable.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, look at this
guy,
man.
What are you, a big tough guy from Oklahoma? Is that what you are?
I'm doing my job. I'm asking questions. That's all I'm doing.
You're out here acting like an idiot. I'm not out here to be insulted by you or anybody. Not by him, not by you, not by the WWF, and certainly not by all these spoonheads out in the audience.
I'm just doing my job, asking a question. Don't you think you overreacted?
And I'm telling you that you're stupid and you need...
I don't need that, I'll tell you that.
You need, maybe, for me...
Hey, listen.
To finish off what I started in Kuwait, maybe that's what you need.
No, I don't need...
Maybe that's exactly
Now look at this,
what
McMahon.
You need.
Look at this!
All right. Hey, come on. Hey, come on.
Hold on.
Where did Ken Shamrock? No. Shamrock's in there. Shamrock now. Shamrock! Watch Vader! Shamrock wants Vader! What a bully! What a bully!
Vader time, it's gonna be hard time.
Oh my goodness, it will be hard time indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Ken Shamrock against the man they call Vader. No holds barred on the 11th of May, live on pay-per-view from Richmond, Virginia. Ah, yeah.
And look forward, ladies and gentlemen, to this Sunday night when Ken Shamrock goes no holds barred with the man they call Vader. Here's another look at ABC's Most Dangerous Man.
The mold for the man has delivered a fighter, a physical and emotional modern-day gladiator cultivated in this stature by time.
As a kid, you know, the things that happened to me, I fought from anger. I was really good at football. I was really good at wrestling, you know, collegiate wrestling. But I took that out because of the things that happened to me in life. I used my anger in football and wrestling. Now I go in and fight with skill. And I'm in control of my actions. Whereas before, I would just, you know, explode.
Triggered by a troubled youth, the teen runaway seemed destined for destruction. But Ken's fate was dramatically altered by a man who would become his father. A man who recognized the promise.
In fact, when he was in high school and even in his early 20s, I said, Ken, you should have been born in gladiator time. Because, you know, he just had that focus and that ability, and he was still angry at this time.
When you want to do, you got to turn it this way, or you got to turn it that way, right? This is the easiest way, right?
And if you knew what he was like before and see how he pulled himself up by the bootstraps.
It's a good one, but...
It's like... building a house. I gave him the blueprints and some of the tools to work with, but he's the one that did the construction.
You gotta put your arm in. Yeah, we won't put that on yet.
Now, truly at home with his wife Tina and their four children, Shamrock's family life provides more than balance. It is his anchor.
There you go. Just don't put it on yet. Wait till you guys go out. You know, that's one thing that as I was growing up that I didn't have was a family. My family was broken up. My brothers were scattered all over the place. And so to me, like, family is the biggest thing as far as support in anything.
Shamrock's arduous path has provided added appreciation for his life today.
All right. Nice hit. Good run, Ryan. Hey, that's the way to stick the ball, Ryan.
You better pay attention.
Pressure and all, you hit the ball. Good job.
That's good.
Now that I had my children, this is where my change came about. I became important with my children, with my family, and I couldn't lose that. I became a person. And so now I don't do the event because I want to be important or because I become somebody when I do it. I do it now because of the expectations I have of myself. I basically go from, you know, I'm at home, I hug my wife, I hug my children, I go out the door, I fly to where I'm going, I talk to people, I'm another human being. But when I step into the arena, just the arena, don't have to be the ring, but just in the place where the event's gonna be, my focus starts to come in now. I go into a zone. It's my own zone. No one else can enter that zone. It's like a basketball player or a football player or somebody that goes out for their event. They put themselves in a zone or in their own space, and no one can enter that space.
Interwoven within the fabric of his emotions remains the soul of a warrior. Uniquely gifted and experienced at beating the odds, he is now set to define his legacy.
There's one thing I've been waiting for my 8 years of no holds barred fighting. There's always been a question asked to me. What if you fought Mike Tyson, who would win?
The reason why I made the challenge, the reason why I want to make the challenge, is because that question is always asked to me. You know, I respect his ability as a boxer. I don't respect some of the things that he has done. Yeah, he was probably lost and gone down different things, but you can't keep going back on that and blaming other people, and that's what he does. He blames other people for his problems, and to me, that's a bully.
Bullies, yes, are here in the World Wrestling Federation. Bullies are just about everywhere.
Let me ask you.
For all would-be challengers, a caveat should be recognized within Ken Shamrock's credo.
I think Vader wants a try.
I don't see failure, you know. That word just doesn't mean in your mind. You do whatever it takes.
What?
Hey, wait, he's right here in front of us.
Go ahead and talk now, Shamrock.
No. Hey, you've got your match in the ring.
That interview I started in
the ring. You better get your butt back in the ring before I take you down right here, right now. If you want it to happen right now, I think we can make that happen.
Get up in the ring, Vader. Come on.
Come on.
Get him, Vader. Get him, Vader.
I'll knock you down, boy. I'll get on top and I'll beat the stuffing out of you.
Get him, Vader. Get him. We're back live, ladies and gentlemen, Green Bay, Wisconsin, the Brown County Expo. In the shadow of Lambeau Field, home of world champion Green Bay Packers. And right now, the man they call Vader is really taking it to Goldust. And every time he gets the advantage, he looks right at you, Ken Shamrock.
Yeah. Well, when we get in the ring, I can tell you this. It ain't going to be won by no pinfall. There's going to be a beating, and it's going to be on somebody. And I can tell you that somebody's going to be, and that's going to be Vader. I'm going after him with everything I have. I dislike this guy very much.
Are you telling me, Shamrock, that you think you could knock out Vader? Huh? You talk about that song.
Doesn't matter what I tell you, because you're ignorant to this kind of stuff. Yeah.
Oh, is that right?
But I'm gonna jump in the ring and beat the snot out of him.
Is that right? He will squash you like the bug that you are.
Hey, anything can happen in the World Wrestling Federation. Do you think you'll take him? Yeah, well, I know you think you'll take him, but nonetheless, by submission or by knockout?
Well, I prefer to make him tap out, because the bully that he is would humiliate him.
Yeah. No doubt. But have you ever faced a man 450 pounds before?
No, Vader's big, strong, and I know I'm in for a task. I know I'm in probably for a really tough fight, but I tell you what, that's what I'm about. I'm about getting in there and challenging myself. And I look at this as a challenge, and I love this challenge because I dislike who I'm gonna get in the ring with.
It will be live, ladies and gentlemen, this Sunday night.
Oh, no doubt about that, folks. It's also gonna be live this Friday night. Huge event this Friday night. Tickets still available for the big event in Hamilton, Ontario this Friday, not to mention this Saturday. What a spectacular in the Catholic Youth Center in Scranton, Pennsylvania. Tickets are going fast for that one. And of course, great seats are still available at the Coliseum box office in Richmond, Virginia this Sunday, a cold day in hell. Be with us live in Richmond. And then next Monday, 1 week from tonight, we're gonna be in the Bob Carpenter Center. Oh boy, Newark, Delaware. Get your tickets now for that one. They're going fast.
Goldust there, displaying tremendous strength. 450-pound Vader down on the canvas, but maybe not for long.
Vince, I don't mean to interrupt, but, you know, Vader better take a little more tension on his match, because he'll lose this one to Goldust, because Goldust, as far as I'm concerned, is a top contender here. So if he doesn't focus, he's going to end up losing this.
And that's what it's all about, is focus. And Vader, unquestionably, right now is focused. Uh-oh. Whoa!
Oh,
no.
Yeah.
Don't tell me we're going to see. Here we go.
When it slows down and Vader can use his mass, use his strength, I don't know if anybody can beat him. Take a look, Shamrock. You're looking into your future right now.
Shut up.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Vader with a victory, and he's looking right at Ken Shamrock, right in his eyes.
Here is your winner.
And Shamrock is it breaking.
Vader.
No holds barred, ladies and gentlemen.
Submission or knockout. It's real simple. Somebody's going to tap out or somebody's going to be knocked out.
Ken, best of luck to you this Sunday.
Thank you. Get your tapping arm ready.
wouldn't know what you're talking about.
All right, and Vader looking down at Shamrock continually.
Shut up.
You'd be playing Mr. Vader's game, obviously, if you get up, Ken.
Yeah, go ahead, get up, Ken.
Come on. You want me going in?
Oh, yeah.
Don't do that.
Oh, yeah, please.
Don't do that.
Please, go ahead, big guy. You're tough.
What do you got to gain by doing it now?
A good butt kicking on worldwide TV. That's what he's got to gain. You want me in there? What does it look like?
Oh, yes.
Oh, God.